Hey guys, it's Jillian, and we are back with another stream in Adobe Animate. And today, we're gonna keep it low-key, as per usual. we're gonna get started. I think we're still gonna tinker around, and again, I've played with this a little bit before, but not in depth. So I think, you know, we're just gonna play around with different shapes, build and draw with shapes, and then try to animate it at the end. So yeah, stay with us. I think I kinda wanna make a traffic cone. Or hopefully. We can get the color settings right. I hope that everybody is having a good Tuesday. I know that it's starting to get a little bit more stressful with, you know, finals coming up. There we go. So I know we're almost at the finish line, so almost there. No, that's not what you want to hear, but okay, we're still figuring out our vertices, and you know, playing around with making shapes. Sometimes I like to do things the hard way. And just keep hitting the undo button. There we go. Just needed a different rectangle tool. Again, we're just gonna keep tweaking until we get how things wanna look. Sometimes a traffic cone is a little bit domed at the top. kind of I'm finding that it's kind of similar to Adobe Illustrator, but still not quite the same. I think I definitely made that harder than it had to be, but I'm pretty okay with how it came out. Going to see if I can maybe make something a little bit easier. Definitely have a lot of anchor points to delete. learning together, folks, that's for sure. Bear with me, folks. Okay, we're almost there.
Okay, I think I'm finally at a point where I like this. we're gonna take a little bit of a break, and when we come back, we can actually do something fun with it.
Hey guys, we're back, and we're actually going to take our thing now and try to make it into a little animation. So let's I'm also kind of making this up on the spot, so bear with me. Maybe, I don't know, I feel like traffic cones kind of get beaten up throughout the day, so. So I know last time we kind of drew on top of things so that they kind of moved with the between each frame. So I want to be able to manipulate just one object frame by frame. So let's go to like I said, you guys, you are learning right along with me. So if this is up your alley. You like to learn in real time. Well, that is great to hear. And for the rest of you, I apologize. Okay.
Steps are almost the same as in the previous videos, so let's go to animate. First of all, we need this illustrator path in the future. So I select it now and copy it with Command or Control C and use it later. Now we'll first convert this arrow into a symbol. Select the arrow, right click, and then click Convert to Symbol. I'll name this symbol Arrow 1 and click OK. Now that we've got a symbol, we've got to go to the Cloud Symbol's own timeline to animate it there. Double click the arrow to do this. We are now in the symbol's own timeline. First, we make a basic motion tween like we did in the second video when we animated the cloud. To do this, I first right click on the arrow, then create motion tween. Animate now asks you to convert the arrow to a symbol again. Just click OK to let Animate do this for you. First, make sure your playhead is at the end of the motion tween, and then move the arrow to the right hand side of the pipeline. Let's test this animation by pressing Enter. The animation is now too fast, so I drag the end of the motion tween to 6 seconds. I think that'll be long enough. I press Enter again, and I think the speed is fine now. Of course, the arrow is not moving along the path yet. What we're going to do now is swap this motion path with the path we've copied earlier. To do this, you must first select the motion path, and then all you have to do is paste. We have to move the path up a little to make it fit on the main path. So I first click on it and then move it to the right place. Press Enter now to test the animation. As you can see, the arrow is not rotating in the right direction yet. The only thing we have to do to make this happen is to select the motion tween, and then check the Orient to Path option in the Properties panel. As you can see, the arrow now moves nicely along the path. Click on Scene 1 to go back to the main timeline. I've already repeated all steps on the other arrow, so when we test this animation in the browser by going to Control Test.
Okay, so we're gonna try a little bit of that to see if we can take some of those principles and not have to add and subtract every time we want to animate a singular object. Thank you. That's not what I wanted. Well, it did something. Not quite. What we had in mind. Okay, maybe converting to symbol wasn't quite what I was going for. Let's try this out again. Okay, let's try this again. We are going to just keep on trying until something happens, you know? Okay. Not giving up, guys. There we go. Okay. You know, something happened and it wasn't not cool, you know what I mean? Yeah, and I feel like traffic cones just kind of, well, I don't know actually. I feel like at some point somebody has definitely hit a traffic cone. Especially since there's so much construction going on out and about. It's bound to have happened, right? Anyway. I feel like the day in the life of a traffic cone is not as rosy as we think it is. Also, it's not the hardest thing in the world to animate. Just like getting progressively worse as, you know, the traffic in the day goes on.
Okay.
I always like to go back and just kind of watch it unfold every time I add something. So,
So we can see the progress or the opposite progress. You know, from a healthy looking traffic cone to pretty pathetic, beaten up one. Gonna go back and not have the points in.
Well,
that's the only way to do it. Thanks, Mod. So I think, yeah, that just about wraps it up for today. Thanks for joining me. Yeah, have a good Tuesday and a fabulous week.